Okay, good. Okay, guys, how are you? It's like all of a sudden a customer just calls and says, can I get a quote? I'm like, oh my God, I've been sitting here like all morning, and 5 minutes before this starts, he's like, I need a quote. Broker life, broker life. But anyway, nice to meet you guys. Are you guys, you're on Zoom, right? Everybody's on Zoom? Okay. Yeah, so I'm on Zoom from the Fort Worth, Texas area. And I've been a broker for about 18 years total. I was with Landstar, about 16, almost 14 years. And I'm as a broker agent. And then I also did training. And then I still do the training. And then I branched out on my own as a freight broker. So it was basically about the same thing. Instead of working for another company as an agent, you're doing the exact same thing, working for your own self as a broker. So there's really not that much difference. It's just that as a broker, you got all these expenses. Oh my God. You got to pay for your surety bond. You got to pay for your boards and your TMS and all that. But then on the good side of it, you don't have to split your commission with anybody. So, you know, we're all business owners. So we kind of decide what we want to do. But you guys are in such a great situation right now, man, just to be able to find loads for drivers. There's tons of loads out there, tons of loads on the load board. And then plus, you know, you can go out and get your own customers too. So you're going to keep busy. There's no such thing as I'm busy, I'm bored. If you're not busy, you got to make yourself busy. That's what I always tell my people when they say, I don't have anything to do, it's slow. No such thing as being slow. Everything has to be shipped. So you're never slow. You just got to make it not slow. So what I'm going to talk to you guys about is this. What makes a broker want to work with a dispatcher? That's kind of the biggest thing right now. Now, you know, with all the media and everything, there's always in Facebook, social media. I was on Facebook a few minutes ago, and I was reading these texts from this group. Brokers suck. Brokers steal money. Brokers blah, 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 blah. And I'm like, oh my God, all I did was say hello, okay? I just said hello, you know? And then look at your profile, broker. So I always try to get the brokers and the dispatchers to work together because we need each other, guys. We really need each other. Sometimes the customers will give loads to brokers if they have a lot of loads, say they may have 10 loads or so. And rather than talk to 10 different drivers, they might want to just talk to one broker in case there's some issues with it. Sometimes customers will give the freight directly to the carrier, you know, and that's good too. So whatever the customer wants to do, but we need each other. Drivers, I mean, sometimes I hate just driving my SUV like 20 miles. I just cannot imagine having to drive 2,000 miles. Get to the other end, and then you got to look for another load. Are you serious? When you can just have a dispatcher that can take care of that for you. If I was a driver, I would definitely have a dispatcher, definitely. But this is the deal. As a broker, we go through a lot to get these customers, cold calling. There's a bunch of brokers out there that are very competitive. We're always competing with rates. So when you actually get a customer, man, you want to protect it with everything you have. I mean, and customers are about updates. That's the number one thing you have to do to be a broker to keep a customer. You have to update them. And by this, I mean this. If a customer gives you a load that picks up at 9 o'clock in the morning, you have to let the customer know like around 8 o'clock, hey, the driver's 10 minutes away. You know, if the load is supposed to be delivered in 2 days at 8 o'clock, you can't wait until 8 o'clock to say, hey, the driver's running late. He had an accident. If the driver's been there waiting to get loaded for 2 hours, you can't wait until he's been there for 6 hours to say, hey, oh my goodness, he's not loaded yet. The customer won't pay me detention then. If I don't let that customer know in 2 hours that the driver is having problems getting loaded, when it's time to ask for detention, the customer will say, oh, well, if I would have known about it, I could have gotten loaded, which is not true, but it's kind of an out for the customer not to pay detention. So the brokers that the dispatchers that I love working with are the ones that update me. I might have five loads and I have a dispatcher that, man, the minute the driver gets there, I'm getting an email, not a call, because sometimes it's hard to, you get the calls all confused. Was this driver, was this dispatcher? With an email, the driver arrived 10 minutes ago, waiting to get loaded. Okay, the driver's been there for 2 hours. He hasn't got loaded yet. Just wanted to let you know. Okay, the driver's loaded. Bam, 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 driving, everything is happy. 2 days later, the driver's at the shipper. The driver's been there for 2 hours. The driver is loaded. As soon as the driver is loaded, I expect, you know, to get a signed bill of lading so I can let my customer know that the driver's loaded. Okay, so if I call my customer and say, hey, the driver's unloaded, it's just like, oh, really? I don't see a signed bill of lading. It's not unloaded. It is not delivered until they get a signed bill of lading. Now, say they're working with 25 brokers. The brokers that give them the updates are the ones that they're going to keep because they don't have time to constantly ask brokers, is he loaded yet? Is he delivered yet? How long has he been there? They'll cut you. I will lose that customer so fast after about two or three times of doing that because they just don't have time. So I'm going to work with the dispatchers that automatically give me that information because I'm doing everything possible to keep that customer. If it's a dispatcher and the dispatcher calls on the load, if I was a dispatcher, first thing I would say is, hey, my driver's going to be there next in 2 days. Will you have this load again? If anything else you're working on? Because see, that way I don't have to repost it. You picked up the load on Monday and you know, do a good job. And I have that load again on Thursday and you have a driver there on Thursday. I would love to give it to you. Then I don't have to go through posting the load. The driver's calling, oh my gosh, why is this rate so low? Last time you did a better rate, you know, you're so cheap, you know, you're trying to keep the money, blah, 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 you know, that's all. So I'm saying to you guys as dispatchers, communicate with the brokers and just let them know that you're going to be there, you know, because it makes your life easy. You know, you can make money. It makes our life easy. We can make money. And that's what this whole situation is about, brokers and dispatchers working together. Okay. There's always going to be some issues. You know, you read about, you know, well, some of the carriers don't want to use dispatchers because they're taking too much money. Some of the carriers don't want to use brokers because they're taking too much money. It's about doing your job. The driver is the most important thing in this whole equation, okay? Now, I'm working for the customer and you're working for the driver, but still, the driver is the number one person because there is no freight. There is no freight to move if there's no drivers. So as a broker, I'm very driver friendly. Some brokers are, some brokers aren't, but we have to always keep the driver in, you know, in mind, in our memories. You guys also check out, be sure and check out the paperwork. Like we may be busy and say the load picks up today. Well, you get a confirmation and it says tomorrow's date. You have to check the paperwork because we're all human, so we can all make mistakes. You may get a confirmation from a broker and the broker may say, hey, it's Monday. Can you pick up this load and deliver it tomorrow? Instead of saying yes, check out how many miles it is. Maybe it's 800 miles. The answer would be no, because we're not flying this freight. We're driving it. So just be sure we have to check out each other, make sure the pickup numbers match, the bill of ladings match, hold these brokers to giving you a bill of lading, okay? Because sometimes there's so much freight and brokers may just say, oh, the bill of lading is gonna be there and he can just pick it up there. Well, yeah, he may pick it up there. It may be the wrong bill of lading. So believe me, as brokers, we all have a bill of lading. It's just that some are a little lazy about getting it to the dispatcher. So, you know, just kind of hold us to that. Let me see, who else? You guys have any questions so far? Anybody?
Yes, I have a question. Is there a software in this industry where the driver can download the app, and when he's on his way, the he can send a notification to the dispatcher, and the dispatcher can use the same software to notify the broker that the driver is on the way, or he has arrived at the destination, or he started loading, unloading, things like that, to make it a little automated.
Sometimes customers will require that the driver download an app so they can see where the driver is, okay? Most of the time, that doesn't happen. What I do is this. Okay, here we go. Does everybody have an iPhone?
Yeah.
Okay, on your iPhone, there's a deal on here where you can share location. Have you ever done that before, like on your... when you send your messages, there's a little deal where you can share your locations. Okay, it's on there. So what I always do, if I'm not working with the dispatcher, if I'm working with the driver, I'll say, do you mind that we share locations throughout this trip? That way I can always see where he is and I don't have to call and bug the heck out of him. You know, I can, my customer, they're like, where's your driver? Oh, he's, you know, over in so-and-so town, you know. So that way, as a dispatcher, I would always try to share locations. It's something that's free, something that's easy, and most drivers won't care, you know, because it just tells the location where they are. It doesn't really tell where they actually are.
Oh, that macro point, right, Brenda? Macro point uses.
Mm-hmm.
Or like Amazon uses their own application. They can track.
They can track, yeah. Yeah. So yeah, some customers ask for have macro point, but if you don't have that, or if the customer's not requesting it, even if the customers are not requesting me to track a driver, I still want to track it on my phone just for my own. Because I hate having to call the drivers in their driving. You know, they've got to look at their cell phones and it takes them, you know, they get distracted. So I would just rather be able to do that. And it works real good. Something that's really simple and free. Okay.
Brenda, when you said that to hold the broker accountable for the bill of lading, do you mean like after we book the load and we deliver it to ask them for that information?
Well, okay. Whenever you book a load with anybody, you have to know what to pick up. There can be mistakes. Say, for example, if I have 10 loads picking up at the same location, but they're all going to different cities. If a driver just walks in and says, hey, I'm here to pick up a load going to blah, 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 they may give him the wrong information if he is not able to show them something. So what I suggest you do, if you book a load with a broker, always ask for the bill of lading so you can give that bill of lading to the driver. It's just a checkpoint. If they don't have a bill of lading, you know, which is very unusual because we all get them, a pickup number at the least. But you've got to, I see mistakes happen when this happens. Okay, don't pick up the load and the customer will just give you the pickup number. Well, that works sometimes and sometimes it doesn't. Because if they give you the wrong pickup number, I'm going to be accountable because the customer gives me the bill of lading. If the broker doesn't give it to you, it's not your fault, but it's just, why send the driver pick up the wrong load and get to the delivery and they can't unload him because he's at the wrong location. Not only at the wrong location, he's in the wrong city and state. So just for your own, you know, self. And also get them to print it out. Get them to print it out. I mean, I know a lot of drivers, not a lot, not anymore. Some drivers still have printers and they're still going to truck stop to get faxes. It's like, really? Are you serious? You go to Walmart and pick up a printer for $35. You know, that's crazy. Okay.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Any more questions? No? Okay. Okay, Oksana, you have anything else?
Well, I have a question. What form of communication do you like the best? Email, text, or phone call?
I prefer email. Yeah, and the reason is because, say for example, if I have three loads that are in area code 630 or three loads that are in area code 214. And I've done this before. I've got a text from a 214, but it's not the right one. And I've given the wrong information to the customer. Like, well, the driver's there. And you get a response like, well, how can he be there when he hasn't picked up yet? It's like, okay, bingo. So now I like to get them on email. The reason I don't want them on the phone is because I may put a customer on hold when you call, and then I'll go back to them and I'm kind of like, okay, so what were we talking about? What load was this? If you send it to me on email, I can forward that email right to the customer. Same email, the same email that you send me. I can forward it right to the customer, and it's real easy. But you know, that is something that we, that's very, very important. Usually if a broker, no, I'm just gonna say not a broker. When I book a load with the dispatcher and I've had to ask them for the bill of lading several times, a lot of times I don't use them anymore. Because remember, I wanna be that broker that's like, dang, she always sends us the signed bill of lading as soon as the load is delivered. So we're gonna start giving her more freight. So it's all based, I base my who I use based on how they do for me to keep my customer. That's what my whole goal is. Like, you guys probably are like, you have drivers that you're dispatching for, and I'm sure drivers will keep using you over and over again if you always give them the rate that they want and maybe more. Maybe you have a driver that says, I'm not gonna move my truck for less than $3 a mile. You come on, if you give him loads at $3.50 a mile, he's gonna use you and also tell his other friends about you, which brings up another point, and I'm not gonna stay on long. The load postings. Okay, so now we post loads on the load board with the rate on it. Sometimes we have a rate, sometimes we don't. As a dispatcher, always ask for more money. We generally have it. If we have a postal for $1,500, ask for $1,700. Remember, because you're working for the driver, I'm working for the customer, so I'm trying to give the customer the best rate, but always ask for more. Most of the time we have it, sometimes we don't. Let me tell you when we don't. Say I booked a load and the driver canceled. So I have to find another truck. I don't have a choice. I have to find another truck. So the last truck I may have booked it for $1,700, okay? So the customer might've paid me $1,900 or $2,000, but that truck canceled. I will find another truck for $2,100 if I have to, and take a $100 loss, because I'm trying to keep my customer and you're trying to pay your driver as much as possible. So there's always going to be that little conflict there. But most dispatchers, hey, the good dispatchers, I already know. If I post a load on here for $1,900, I'm already know they're going to ask me for $21, $22. I'm not even going to go through all that. Well, where's your truck? How much? Blah, 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 blah. No, let's just get this load. Okay. All right, ladies. Atsana, you have any more questions?
Thank you so much, Brenda.
Thank you, guys. And good luck to you. You're going into an exciting field. All right, you guys take care.
You too.
Thank you so much. Bye, hon.